In this segment, we're going to cover adjusting the intake valve, cylinder number 4, part 2. Following the same procedure, about the only thing that differs from the procedures is the locations of the valves and your accessibility for each one. I don't know, switching to this side of the vehicle made it better or worse, but it's definitely different. Okay, I got it loose. Going back to our feeler gauge for the intake side, which is just slightly under 6/1000ths of an inch. Make sure you get the right one here. Oil on the gloves makes it difficult. Okay, I've inserted it. Backing that adjuster off about a half a turn. Make sure everything's good and free. Turn it down clockwise till it's snug, about 15, 20 degrees. And I'll switch hands and tighten that lock nut down. Go, and we'll recheck it again. Yeah, if you have any questions or something doesn't seem right, always just check it again. It's a lot faster to check it when you got the valve cover off, the cylinder in the right position, than it is to have to go back and tear all the other components off to have to correct a mistake. And that one feels pretty good. Check and make sure that I got that lock nut good and tight. And that will conclude adjusting the intake valve part 2, cylinder number 4. Please watch our next segment on adjusting the exhaust valve, cylinder number 4, part 1.